Dear Father, I stand today just wanting to say thank you, Lord, for everything that you've done for me. Somebody's going to need you, Lord. Somebody's going to need a friend. Will I stop by to let you know that I know somebody that'll stick closer than a mother? Somebody that'll stick closer than even a father? Well, friend, I'm talking about Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because
yeah.
I know Jesus will never let you down. No, whenever you need. I know Jesus, he'll never let you down.
Whenever
you need the Lord, I know.
Everybody out there, thank you guys so much for tuning in to I've Been Through It, hosted by Gail Davis. I just want to thank my cousin Stevie and his group, God's Anointed and Appointed. You know, this song just blesses my life so much. So hopefully somebody out there has been blessed. Hopefully you guys will support my cousin and his group, and you know, you support you guys, right? So today, the name of the show is I've Been Through It with Gail Davis, right? So the reason for the show is because we just want to tell different stories, different scenarios, different life experience situations that people have been through. They made it through, they got through it, and hopefully we can inspire someone to get through what they're going through. Or maybe you haven't been through it, but maybe you know someone, so you can have them to tune into the show. But we have a couple of special guests today. All of my guests are VIP, you guys. I want y'all to know that. And I thank you guys so much for tuning in. All you guys are beautiful people out there. But I have my really special guest here today, Prophet Michael. We have been knowing each other for a few minutes, you know, and he's going to come and tell you some of his life experiences. We're going to play a couple of videos because he is really out there. He's up and coming. He's rising. You're rising,
amen,
right?
Amen.
He's
amen.
An up-and-coming rising star, gospel rapper. He prophesies through his song. So, you guys, he's going to tell you some things about himself, and we're going to let him go where you want to start. Where you want to start, Mike?
All right. How you guys doing out there, my listeners? And, my name is Prophet Michael, out of Los Angeles, California. I'm out of West Angeles Church of God in Christ, Bishop Charles E. Blake. My pastor. I was raised here in Los Angeles, South Central. As a youth, you know, I was in the church a lot. My grandfather, rest in peace, Elder Morgan, he was a minister when I was a kid growing up in South Central LA. I battled from the church, from the church to the streets. Actually, you know, I'm a PK kid, and my grandfather was a minister. He was a preacher. And I used to battle between the church and the gang banging. I was out in the streets. I would go to church, and then after church services, and you know, you had to come to South Central LA, and I was in the hood. I was always in the hood. And, you know, once you growing up in Los Angeles, you know, you have to be tough. You can't be sour. You can't be a cream puff. You can't be a pootie, as we say. And you just got to be tough. And I battled between church and gangbanging in the streets as a youth.
Okay, so when you say you got to be tough, right? It's cool to be tough in God's kingdom too, right?
Amen.
That's
yes.
The most
oh
part,
yeah.
Right.
Yeah. You got to be firm. So you know, I was firm, and yeah. I had a good ground, good background. But always, you know, that street is calling you, especially in Los Angeles, California.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
The streets is calling you, and you know, I lived in South Central, so you know where the gang banging and the drugs and everything is as coming up at the youth.
Yeah, and there's some neighborhoods. Basically, it's like you really have to just sometimes like
yes.
You can fight it off.
Yes, yes.
So I definitely understand what you're saying because I was real particular about uh-huh. the neighborhoods. You know,
yes.
I had my son, I was raising him, so I was so particular about the neighborhoods.
Right.
But, you know, you could definitely be tough.
Yes.
In God's army. See, that's what God
Amen.
Needs.
Amen.
He needs those tough soldiers out there. So God is calling y'all. You know, he's
yes,
calling,
yes.
Right?
Oh, yeah.
So you grew up and you did a little gang banging. You did
yes.
You did a lot of church.
Yes.
And so,
lots of church.
And so what brought you to the music? Like, how'd you do in school when you
well,
were in school?
Well, actually,
tell
I was.
Tell me this though, Michael. Mm-hmm. First. How'd you do in school when you were in school? Were you gang banging in school, or was your mother getting bad reports from you because you were gang banging, or you was like?
No, I was kind of sneaky with mine. I was a kind of person. Well, you know, I have a good background of parents and grandparents. So they was ministers, and my mom worked for Control Daters and Honeywell. So they had great jobs. I mean, I was brought up very well.
Okay.
I just. Straight away because the streets are calling you. We in South Central LA, when I leave home and leave the schools and leave the church, you going to the playground.
Okay, you going to
going to the playground. First thing you do, you go to the playground and that's where everybody hang out at.
Okay.
So, yes, I was a good student.
Right.
I played football.
Okay.
I played at Chatsworth High School,
okay.
El Camino College, to Northwest Missouri State University, played in a lot of minor league professional football teams.
Really?
Yes, I was a good kid, but it was just,
it was
you
just
got that hood.
Were you like curious? Was it that you was curious, that you had to do it, or you felt like you had to do it to walk
well,
the streets? Or?
Well, actually, my older brother's name Gang Bang, so I was following suit.
Okay.
You know, and that's the way it is in South Central Los Angeles. When you, your brothers and cousins is gang banging, you're going to follow suit.
Okay.
Or you're going to, some kids may not, but I was always around my brothers and cousins and friends, that they was all gangbanging, so I didn't have anything else to do.
So it looked kind of glorified. It looked good to you.
Well,
yeah. So we're not glorifying none of that.
Yes.
But it was looking good
yes.
to you at the time because your brothers and everything was doing
but
it.
But I had a praying mother, praying grandparents that just prayed daily over me, my brothers and over us. So
that's
eventually, God just touched my heart.
Okay.
Eventually, when I was in high school, when I was graduating out of high school, God just touched my heart. Look, you're not going to belong. You don't belong in there. I got a purpose for your life.
Okay.
My life was changed once I got out of high school. I wasn't hanging with the gangbangers.
Okay.
I was playing football and this and that. And my mom was always praying. And, hey, you got to, thrilling me. You got to stay in school. You got to get be somebody. So I just knew deep down that I was somebody. And I knew that. Eventually that I was going to change my life. God was going to change me around for the better.
Okay.
And I can say that would be my testimony because God touched me at the times when it was hard times because I know I've been through it.
Wow.
Only the hands of God can brought me through this.
Amen. Only
so I know that my parents was praying for me the whole time and eventually that, you know, I was going to come out of it, you know, because I'm a strong person.
Okay.
I'm a humble person.
Now, so you said that you were, like, behind the scenes a lot with the music videos with your brothers and different relatives, right?
Well, yeah. When Master P Diddy, all these rappers was coming to California, they come to California, mm-hmm. and I was working on a lot of those music videos behind the scenes.
Oh, okay.
So,
okay.
And then I would introduce my younger brother, which is Cali's Finest, was a gangster group here in Los Angeles, California. And I would introduce them to Ice Cube and everybody. So I was knowing everybody. I'm a friend of Quincy Jones' son, which is Quincy's Jr., QD3.
Okay.
So
him too.
I just, I actually, awesome. You know, I'm a friend of a lot of people in this circular music, but I was always behind the scene, and I used to go to the studios with my brother. I'd say, God, you teach me how to rap. I let the world know your name, because I didn't like the gangster rap. I don't like that. I just, it's not a good message to me. So I listened to it because that's the era we grew up in, but actually, God always spoke to my heart. God was always in my heart, and I would say, God, you teach me how to rap. I let the world know your name, and here I am. Wow. That's Prophet Michael.
I like how you say that he said that he asked God to teach him how to rap. So you wasn't rapping.
I wasn't rapping. No, I wasn't rapping. When I was a kid, I used to sing because my brother Morris Parker passed away, rest in peace. And my brother used to play for the Whispers when I was a kid. He played drums when I was a kid. He played drums with the Whispers. Uh-huh. And when I was a kid, and when Howie Hewitt left Shalimar, my cousin Sid Justin is the singer, lead singer for was the lead singer for Shalimar. Now he sings for the Miracles, the Traveling Miracles.
Wow! So you actually
the music background it was in me, but I didn't like rap. I was able to sing, but I didn't like rap. So how I got into rap, I asked God to teach me how to rap so I can let the world know his name, because I didn't like the message that my brother and other rappers, it was the gangster rap, talked about, because education wasn't edifying to my spirit. So
to your spirit, I like that. I like that. You said teach you how to rap because you wanted to be able to, and you said you would say his name.
Amen.
And that's what you're doing. I heard a couple of your songs and videos, and I really like it, you guys. He is really
from a gangster.
You said,
to a prophet.
God, teach me how to rap.
Yes.
And I will shout your name.
Amen.
To the world, right?
From a gangster to a prophet.
So you guys, we never here on this show to bash anybody.
Amen.
Okay. So we're not even gonna bash the gangbangers. We just gonna say, you guys think about what you're doing, because you're still leaders, you still have little brothers. Like he said, his big brothers, he was watching them, and that's what made him wanna do it. So think about the people around you that's watching you.
Yes.
Do
Amen.
What you do, and just try to make right decisions.
It's not too late.
Try to make the right, the right choices. Because we're not bashing you at all, because all of you guys out there, little kings, sometime, and a lot of times people don't know who they are.
Amen.
But if nobody told you guys, I'm letting you guys know that you guys are kings, you know what I'm saying? But God needs you in his kingdom also to, be warriors for him, right? And so we're not bashing nobody. We love y'all too. We love everybody, right?
Amen. Amen.
We don't love the devil though.
No.
We don't love the devil.
No.
We hate the devil.
No.
Right? Okay, so you have these videos and everything that you're doing. And so how long have you been doing it for yourself, not behind the scenes?
I can say professionally just around 2000.
Okay.
Year 2000, just really getting involved and performing in different churches. As you can see on my bio here, in the year 2008, I was awarded for Hip Hop of the Year with the Luminosity Awards from the LA Messengers. That's the group of James Cleveland, the late James Cleveland Group,
okay.
They organization. And then the year 2010, I was an honoree of Curtis Blow Awards from the LA Hip Hop Church of Christ. And getting around.
Okay, so
I'm
look,
blessed.
You guys, he's talking about his music, but we gonna have him put his money where his mouth is, and we gonna play one of these videos, okay? Are we ready to go?
This is
to,
enjoy life.
Enjoy life. We're gonna go to Prophet Michael and one of his videos. You guys watch this because he's awesome. Okay, he's very awesome.
World premiere. Enjoy Life, featuring Prayers Blackman II, Watch Up Productions.
Oh, okay.
Y'all, I'm enjoying life. Yeah, cause when I was a child, I thought as a child. Now I'm grown up, and I put childish things away. Yeah, now I can enjoy my life to the fullest.
Oh yeah. Oh
yeah, I like that. Come on. Come on, everybody. Just enjoy your life. This world try to pull you down.
Why don't you enjoy your life? Just enjoy
y'all. Check him out.
Enjoy life, y'all.
You matter. What you do? I'm Cali's finest. Don't lie like your highness.
That's all I can say right
now.
All
right,
now,
all right, y'all.
I know you guys enjoyed that video.
Yeah.
I enjoyed that video. We was all sitting up here just rocking and bouncing to the music. Right? Because Prophet Mike is all right. And
yeah.
You know, to the people that's in your band, the music, your whoever did your music, is nice.
Big Jeff from Watch Up Productions.
It is so nice. What's Up Productions. I love it, you guys. So this is what God can do.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying? You know, he
from
had,
a gangster to a prophet.
From a gangster gangsters in the streets to the prophet in the what studios, right?
Amen.
And coming up and doing just big things, right?
Yes.
Like, and see, you guys, this is not his only video.
Yes.
He got some more videos. So you guys got to look him up on what?
On YouTube. Prophet Michael, Enjoy Life, and Just Believe. And I got one more, Lord, I Cry.
Okay, here's this other one called Lord, I Cry. You know it's all.
This video right here is called Just Believe.
Oh, Just Believe. Okay, this is Just Believe. Oh, okay. Prophet Michael, you're all that. I like it.
Thank you.
I like it. It is good.
Yeah. You know you gotta have a vision. Be strong and of good courage, y'all. With prosperity. No, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Just believe, y'all, and live and enjoy your life according to his will, y'all. Come on.
my joy. You give me much more. My life is nearly over. I'm drug free and sober. I believe and I pray. You make a way out of no way, and I thank you every day. Your mercy came my way. You never leave me nor forsake me, so them devils can't take me. I believe in your glory. My folks hear my story, family. I am blessed and highly favored with no more stress. I got my waiver from my Savior Jesus Christ. He saved my life from living in strife. Just believe I
be strong, my brother. Hold on, my sister.
Rocking. He said, hey, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. All you got to do is believe.
Amen.
And that's for everybody out there. All you got to do is believe, right?
That's it. That's it.
That's all you
got to do. You can do all things. Look up to the hills from which your health comes from.
Right.
And believe.
And this is coming from mama, grandmother, granddad. This is coming from prayers.
Yes. Yes.
Of your grandfather, your grandparents, your mother and father.
Well, I say God touched me, you know, this old saying, he touched you in your womb.
Right.
I believe that I was touched in my womb. I believe that I have a purpose in my life, and I'm going forth. I am a visionary. I am a dreamer, and I make my dreams come to true, to pass. I am going out there and perfecting my dreams. I'm going out there and working my dreams. I ain't sitting at home and waiting for somebody to do something. I said I was going to get a record deal. I end up getting a record deal. Okay. I said I was going to do this and do that. I end up doing it, and I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. My songs is on radio. I'm on different stations out of town. Los Angeles, y'all kind of slow here, but I'm coming back to you guys.
Los Angeles, I'm here. Get out there and support Prophet Mike. He's on YouTube all day. You just push up Prophet Mike and, you know, support. You guys, we have to support, right?
Amen.
Exactly. So Prophet Mike, I'm just so in awe of these videos, right? I'm still rocking with the video right now. So do you have any upcoming things that you're finna be doing?
Well, next weekend we have like a little get together for my brother, 62 years old. He's coming from Houston. He's coming here, so we're gonna have a little event for him, which I'm probably gonna perform right there in front of the family and everything.
That's nice.
And Tim Bishop Brown, he has a couple of events coming up. It's not, we don't have the dates right now, but it's a couple of concerts coming up. So just check my Facebook, which is Prophet Michael Willis on Facebook.
You
can check me out on Facebook, and we can go from there.
Facebook, Prophet Michael Willis on Facebook. You guys check him out. On YouTube, Prophet
Michael.
On YouTube, it's
Prophet Michael.
Michael,
enjoy life and just believe.
And just believe. You guys definitely blow his YouTube up. Support.
Amen.
Okay, we have to do that because these are the prayers, right? And this is another thing that I just want to touch bases on. Your mother and them was praying for you. So for anyone out there that's going to that life, you know, and they're not there yet, but they thinking about going to the game, getting in gangs and everything, because sometimes it don't end up good.
Right.
What would you try to inspire somebody about that today?
Talk to your parents. I mean, I know as kids, you guys, I know my son, he never really talked to me as much, but I think it's important. Go to your father, go to your mother and talk to them. Go to your older brother and get some knowledge, get some wisdom. Talk to your grandfather, because I was a person that when I was a kid, I always talked to older folks because they all got all the wisdom. So I want to talk to somebody who's older so I can get some of that wisdom and become wise. But I would say to you, just get some educate yourself, stay in school, stay off the drugs. I mean, go to the parks and become somebody. If you're going to play football, basketball, you know, become somebody. You are somebody. You are somebody. You can become who you want to become.
Yeah.
Just by prayer and faith with God.
And one last thing real quick. This wasn't really even your dream at first, because the way
I was a football player. I should have been in the professionals and played and retired by now. And
yeah.
So
that's just another thing to let everybody know. Even if what you think you're going to do, God probably have another plan for you, right?
He had another plan for me.
He have another plan.
And I'm not finished yet. I think I may be shying away from the ministry, but it's coming. I know it's coming. God is touching, working on me. I'm a work in progress right now, but the music ministry is my calling right now. But I'm not going to stray away too long.
So definitely trust God's plan, you guys, okay?
Amen.
So definitely we're finna go to like a little 2-minute commercial break or whatever. And when we come back with our other guests, our other VIP guests. You know, all our guests are VIP. And we want to thank Prophet Michael.
Thank you so much.
I know you really blessed somebody.
Yes.
You really inspire somebody out there to keep your dream. And even if your dream goes to what God wants you to do, God knows best. Father
Amen.
Knows best,
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
I believe that Father knows best.
Amen.
I think He knows better than
yes.
we do. Okay, so you.
He knew
you
I was going to be here today.
Support, Amen. You guys. Support Amen. Prophet Michael.
Amen.
Support
thank him. You. Thank you, Gail.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. God
thank
bless you.
Thank you so much.
Hey, y'all. Can I get a moment of silence for our folks who's resting in paradise? To my mom, Peggy Campbell, my brother, Big G from Cali's Finest, my uncle, Sidney Justin, Michael Jackson, Whitney Houston, Bernie Mac, Stuart Scott, Trayvon Martin, Michael Brown, Robin Williams, and Pastor Andre Crouch.
Yeah, this for everyone who's missing their folks or they locked up for life. Rest in peace to my grandparents, June, Thelma Justin, Bishop G.E. Patterson, Dr. E.B. Hill Sr., Leah, Johnny Cochran, and Gerald LeBert. And to my mama, we really miss you. George Dawson, Vine and Dyke, and Bishop C.L. Martin, and Don West. We really miss y'all. Lord, it's just like yesterday when you down and cross. And because of your resurrection, Prophet Michael never be lost. See, I toss my wicked ways to be saved, growing up in L.A., you know you can see an early grave. But you made a way for me to stay away from devil prey. So I lay all of my burdens, cause there's nowhere that I can turn to. I miss you when them devil diss you, and I'm going through all the same thing you already been through. And mama, I really, really miss you too. All the things you done for me, no one would do. When I had the flu, you knew what to do. When I hung with the crew, you pray so I'll come home to you. And I never put a lady above you. And I give my dues to my grandparents, cause they preach first. The death of Morris Parker, my body hurts. So I miss you all as I thirst. That's how I'm gonna end my verse. Yeah, I wanna say rest in peace to Sherry Anderson, Reverend C.L. Franklin, Dr. Earl Pleasant Sr., Ernestine and Lois Jackson, Timmy and Ricky Quarles, Eazy-E, and Selena, Francis Benson, Billy Facey, Merlin Monroe, Elvis Presley, to Ace Capone, and Cornelius Bumpus. We miss. As I walk through the valley of death, I fear no evil. There, never leave me, nor forsake me. Devil, you know you ain't equal, cause I'm shining in the crowd. So would you allow for me to pay my respect to whom I never will forget? Mr. and Mrs. King, they were on the same team. They sang the same dreams, just like Rosa Parks, Malcolm X, Bob Marley, Dennis Brown, Peter Tosh. You know they be jamming in God's tropical parks. James Cleveland, Marvin Gaye, Nat King Cole. Everything y'all touch really turned into gold. Oh, didn't Richard Pryor and Red Fox made us laugh and cry right off of our socks? Bob Hope spoke those punchline jokes, but show what happened to all my folks. Biggie and Pop, y'all raps have never stopped, so we really miss y'all all a lot. Yeah, this to all the people who we missing. To Bojangles, Sammy Davis Jr., Billy Preston, Jeffrey Pearson, to Kwame Harris, Willie Barlow, Jerry Moore, yeah, and
and Lorena Waters, Big Pun, and Jam Master J. See, we be missing y'all. Come on. This for all my folks done and locked up for life. The spirit of y'all blessing us so we can see the light. And despite of you, Mr. President, them soldiers lost their stripes. They gave up their own life trying to save our life. And you know what happened to those 911 victims? This colorblind massacre, man, that really, really hit them. Natasha Harding's death made us want to really get them. But the Lord said vengeance is here, so it is what it is. The loss of black heroes, man, we still paying their cost. And we gotta sing the old Negro spirituals so they won't frost. You know Jimi Hendrix was the original boss. Mahalia Jackson, James Brown, man, we feel the loss. Whether you're a teacher, doctor, or a fireman, the Lord gives and takes, and he really don't make mistakes. So it don't matter if you're black, white, yellow, or brown. When the Lord calls, you gotta be ready to go uptown. Yeah, this to everybody who's out there, who's missing someone. Mayor Tom Bradley.
Okay, thank you guys for joining us back here at I've Been Through It, hosted by Gail Davis. And I just want to give a shout out to some people, thank some people for making this all happen. We want to thank Roscoe Media Center, Roscoe Chicken and Waffle. We want to thank Johnny Morris, Kino, Melissa, my girl, she had me on her show, Community With Me. And I want to thank our tech team. You know, Kevin back there, he making it happen every time, you guys. And that was Prophet Michael's song, too.
Amen.
And that song is called what again?
Missing You.
Missing You. So you guys, look him up on YouTube, support him. So right now, we have another special VIP guest. And her name is Carissa Foreman. Carissa Foreman. You know, I know her. She's my girl right there. You know, I just had to have her on the show because she have a very interesting story, too, and she just want to share her experience with someone out there, and hopefully it'll encourage someone to get through what they're going through right now. You know, because everybody's going through a lot of stuff right now, you know, and we have different situations, different scenarios, but we're trying to bring the different scenarios so we can encourage some people, make it through it. If I made it through, you can too. Clarissa made it through, you can too. Carissa, go ahead and start where you want to start, Carissa.
Yes, Gail, this story is about don't let no one destroy your inner peace.
Amen. And I like that.
Like you said, some people went through it, and I did go through it. And I'm glad that, like you said, without God, you can't go through anything without him. You have to go through it with him to survive. Without him, the devil will destroy you.
Yeah.
You have to have him at all times first.
At all times. And put him first, too, huh?
If
we put him first, we're definitely going to be okay.
Yes.
Through everything.
Then, yes, as your day go along, you have to think about him first. If somebody try to get you upset, you have to think about him first.
Yes.
The devil will destroy you every time. So you have to think about him always.
Yeah.
But, like I said, a lot of women is out there going through a whole lot, and I have a lot of girlfriends just like you. And I was married, and I just wanted to explain my story.
Okay.
And maybe somebody will probably go through the same thing or probably went through the same thing. And
that's what it's all about.
I just said, you know, maybe I should tell my story.
Yeah, I think, yeah.
Hopefully, it will help some people.
Hopefully. That's what the goal is.
Yes.
To help someone out there.
I've always been an easygoing person, and I'm not the kind of person that will curse somebody out. But I feel like sometimes people just take advantage of your inner kindness. Peace, and if you allow it, they will destroy it. So
exactly.
Personally,
exactly.
I was pushed many more than once, and I come out of it just through God, just friend of God. So my story is about how me and my ex-husband separated after like 14 years, and how your own family could help destroy your relationship. And I just wanted to say that at the time I found out my marriage was ending, I had no idea why at the time. I just knew that it wasn't working out because he wasn't answering my questions about stuff he was doing. And eventually I get to find out that he had a relationship with somebody that used to come to my swimming pool, a girlfriend of mine. It's one of my close girlfriend. They all come to my pool and swim in the pool with their kids. They all have people, married couples, just like me and him. And they come in the summer and swim in the pool and have fun. He was never around at the time. He always and get to find out this one of the same girls that was supposedly be one of my best friend or girlfriend that comes to swim in the pool in the summertime. She start dating my husband.
Wow.
She was a married woman too. And wow. And how I find out is because my daughter was 6 years old at the time. Mm. My youngest baby said, "Mommy, I was at school waiting for Daddy, and he didn't. And I yelled at him, and he didn't look at me, and he came to school to pick up this lady, Lonnie's kids that always come to the house and swim in the pool." And I said, "What?" And he did not reply. He's just, I keep him saying hello.
Wow.
He said, "Daddy, Daddy, Daddy." And he's not listening. He don't look. He just kept on walking with the two kids, two of her kids.
Are you serious?
I was like, wow. So it was really, really a shock when she come. She was crying. And actually, I picked her up that day, and she's like, she was surprised that he was there. She thought he came to pick her up. And it blew my mind then, and he said, no, it wasn't him. So it was very devastating.
Are you serious?
My daughter don't know her own daddy in a school that is practically 95% white and 5% black, she doesn't know her own daddy, right?
That was
the shock of the whole thing. It hurt me so bad at the time that it wasn't because of what he did, it's because he hurt my daughter.
Yes.
So she's a child, and for her to experience that at that age was very, very...
And she knew who she saw. She knew who her daddy was.
You know how he dresses. You know how he walks. I mean, it's like that's... They're like this. They were like best friends. So how would she not know her own daddy? He picks her up at school almost every day. Take her to McDonald's almost every day. Wow. I pick her up maybe once or twice a week. And that day, she was so devastated. She cried. She was crying like crazy when I picked her up.
Oh, my gosh.
So anyway, it went from there. Of course, he denied that there was nothing going on, that wasn't him. Later on, I found out that she claimed she was pregnant. So, it went from there. So, she was lying at the time.
Okay.
But once the husband found out about the relationship, her husband, he took away the kids from her. And they separated.
Wow.
And me and him still was together at the time.
Uh-huh.
But we were traveling like maybe once a year, going back and forth to my country, to Belize at the time.
Okay.
So
okay.
I enjoy going to my country, of course.
Awesome. I want to go to Belize.
We went down there many times and, you know, have a good time.
I want to go to Belize, Carissa. When we going? No, okay.
I get to find out that my sister-in-law of 10 years having two nephews, that, you know, there was something going on, but I didn't believe it. I just ignore it because I couldn't believe that something was going on.
Okay, so you said this was your sister-in-law down there in Belize. They have, okay, two nephews. Okay.
Beside that, I heard stories about other women, but I'm not the kind of person that I have to see something that really happens before I just jump to conclusion. I'm not that type of person that always, the first thing I hear, I believe. I'm not that type of person. I'm very open-minded.
Okay.
So, anyway, but it was very painful, that first scenario. And then 5 years later, we start breaking up over this girl. 5 years later, my nephew comes to my house and says, I haven't seen my nephews for like five or eight years then.
Mm.
And my nephew goes and said, I have a sister that is Tiffany's, which is my daughter's sister also. I was like, what?
Really?
So it's not a shocking blow that I have my daughter has a sister out there with my sister-in-law.
Are you serious?
Right. And they were together. My brother and her was together over 12 years, that relationship. And they had separated at the time.
When he was going back to Belize, he was going back to Belize to actually...
He was
making some babies.
She got pregnant by him. And
so once or...
I felt like something just tore me up inside, like my whole body got... My heart just, like, dropped and...
Yeah.
I thought I was going to fall.
Because you guys was married, 14 years?
It was before 14 years was up. This is after the time was up. I heard all these stories. So it was like, we already separated by then. And I hear this other blow of, you know.
Yeah.
So it's like what I survived. I was talking about it a lot. I was talking to my friends about it a lot. I was talking to my kids. I was talking about him a lot. Because I feel like we were very close and I was shocked about all these stories.
Yeah, because that's hurtful.
I didn't know who I was living with. So it was
sleeping
devastating.
With the enemy,
and
huh?
I remember going to sleep every night having a grandma near my bedside, having a shot, just to try to fall asleep.
Trying to get through
sleep.
It, right?
I was going to work every day, doing my work. But every time I turned around, I was, you know, I was crying, not to let people know I was crying because it was so painful.
So,
but like I said, I also want to thank my girlfriend, Val Young, because after I moved and separated from him, she's in the music industry, and she had me going to every movie star house you could think of, and we
really?
Were having a lot of good times. So we helped forget
some of the movie stars that you did visit, like what it kind of like, you know, just going to the gatherings and stuff helped
parties,
you get through it.
Parties.
So can you like name a few? Is it okay to name a few? Like,
well, Eddie Murphy was number one. He's, you know, he's big, okay. and well, I should say celebrities.
Mega. Yeah, he's mega.
You know, Richie and Rick James. So those are the people.
Oh.
Snoop Dogg, been to his house many times.
Okay.
Quincy Jones' son's house.
Okay, the same with the first guest.
Yeah, Granada Hills.
Okay.
So we, you know, so I had some good times through her, you know, very good times. So she helped me forget most of my pain because I was like, I was partying a lot with my girlfriends.
Yeah.
So it helped me got over, you know, my past. And my daughter was like my best friend. We go to eat. A lot after the separation, it was a big drastic lifestyle, from living a luxury lifestyle to, you know, just having ends, a paycheck to paycheck, you know, before I could really live the nice lifestyle. So it wasn't that easy.
But, you know, so funny, God was getting you prepared. Right. He was taking you to these different celebrity homes and letting you have a good time and bring you out of it and trying to put your mind on something else.
Right.
So
it really helped. It really helped. We were barbecuing 12 o'clock in the night sometimes.
Are you serious?
Valley. We had a lot of good times. We had
wow.
Like I said, if it wasn't for them, I mean, every holiday, Rick would call me and I'd go over and cook.
Are
and
you
we
serious?
Have a lot of, you know, good times. So I said, if Mike Tyson.
Are you serious?
Everybody, you know, we have. I had a lot
he was,
of,
oh, so he was like, come cook.
Come over and just give us money to cook and buy liquor for everybody, whatever they want. He just give us the money and we barbecue right on the spot.
Are you serious, Teresa?
So I had some good people that helped me forget about him. So I just
shout out to you guys, all of you guys that she's talking about right now. Shout out to you guys.
Yeah, I just want, you know, to thank all of them.
Yeah.
And to know women out there, sometimes you think you know your husband, but. No, you never know them.
Wow.
The things, and I asked him why we separated the first time, and he told me this lame story about he heard that I was dating a white man at the time, but it was a white man that was in my life because he was trying to get my daughter in a movie.
Okay.
But it wasn't in my life, like, you know, sexual way. It was just pure business.
Yeah, yeah.
And I did tell one of the girls the story.
Okay.
And they took it the wrong way. They thought I was going to see him to get script from him. Every time they redo the script, he gave me a copy of it, and I had to go through it with him. But it was never a sexual relationship.
But even at that, if he thought something and he wasn't sure, he still could have came to you and talked to you, right?
He talked about it. And he told me, he has proof that we have an affair. He had a videotape. And I'm like, well, that videotape cannot exist because I never had no relationship with him. And I said, I could take you to his office and let us... You know, get to know who
talk.
You are and
what
you are. And he refused to go to the man's office. Well, obviously, you don't want me to prove that there's nothing going on. But like I said, it hurt me because I knew that it was a lie from, you know, you're not in a relationship with the person.
Right.
You know, you don't have nothing to hide. And somebody want to create a story just because they see you with a... It was, you know, he was from Jerusalem, you know. He was very nice. He's actually a writer. He wrote Pretty Woman. So he
really?
Was very big, yeah.
And so he was trying to get your daughter into movies.
He was writing a new movie, and he saw my daughter, and he thought that she would be the perfect picture of what he had in his mind. Of
really?
So
did that ever pan out?
No. We went through all this breaking up around that time and everything. Oh. Rain.
Yeah,
it was devastating, and I couldn't sleep for 2 years. Literally had a good night rest.
Are you serious? See, I'm getting chills right now, you guys. I mean, somebody out there watching, I don't know if you're getting chills too, but it's giving me chills, you know, for real. Because that is, you say you couldn't sleep for 2 years.
Yeah, really. So I got over it.
That's a lot.
I'm like I said, if it wasn't my girlfriends, Mary Jane girls, Candy. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Everybody, you guys were there for me, and Diane Carter, you know, Young, you know.
That's so nice. You're going to make me cry. I mean, I'm just saying because God sent people in your life.
They're my friends. And
to get you through it.
Yeah, they... we had so much fun together that they really helped me forget that I had that life.
Wow.
Yes.
She's sort of Mary Jane girls.
Oh, we're still best friends. We're still close.
And you said someone else.
Ty James is Rick James' daughter.
Yeah. Wow. So you were just out there and
watched her grow up.
You watched her grow up.
I watched Bria Murphy grow up. I've been to, you know, I was going to Eddie House all the time, you know, barbecuing, having fun. I watched her. What's his name was his doorman at the time, Charlie, when I first met them. Charlie Murphy.
Really?
Yes. Wow. He was still working for Eddie.
Okay. Well, you know, keep the money in the family, y'all. Yeah, keep it in the family. Yeah. I like that, right? Keep it in the family. Mm-hmm. That is so, you know what, that is such a touching story because the fact that she had friends, so we really need our friends. You know, our friends got to be there. They should be
and
there.
And not only that, when I was in Eddie's house, I was always laughing.
Really?
Because he had all the
that's
comedians.
Amazing.
He actually taught a lot of comedians how to become real good.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
I feel like that is God. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
Because God put those people in your life to help you get through it. Where you didn't even like, you know, I mean, it was hard. And I'm sure you had some times where you cried still.
No, I'm over it. No, we're friends. We're not close, but we're friends.
Okay, you got
friends. I can talk to him like a brother.
Pain. Yeah, so you've forgiven him.
I've been forgiving him. I had to forgive him to move on. There's no way you could get over anything unless you forgive the person.
Amen. Say that again, Clarissa.
You have to forgive to move on. Yes.
Okay.
You have to forgive to move on and for you to get your inner peace. And that's what I held on to, my inner peace. I love to stay peaceful.
Right.
And if I didn't know how to do that between me and God, that's how I survived. Or it was, you know, many nights to like, I feel like I didn't want to wake up, but.
Oh, wow.
You know, like I said, I'll never allow anybody to take away my inner peace again. Never.
Never.
Don't ever put 100% into anything. Except God.
Except God, you guys. Put 100% to God. And yeah, or try. At least definitely try, right? Because he is definitely.
God is number one.
He's number one. And do he bless us when we don't even deserve it?
Exactly.
When we don't even deserve it, he's still good and he still blesses us.
Exactly.
And I'm so blessed and touched by that story because these people that was in your life, they just like.
They were like angels around me. They made me laugh every day. They made me happy every day. They made me forget that I even had a bad life. You know, like a very devastating life.
Well, how blessed are you?
I am blessed.
You are blessed, girl, because that is an amazing story.
It's so
you got
wonderful.
To hang out with celebrities.
All the time. Yes.
And they just made you laugh. And who was that you said to say, come on over here and barbecue?
Oh, yeah.
You said it was Mike Tyson. No, not Mike Tyson. He brought the money.
Mike used to come over Bald Young House, and we were neighbors at the time. After
okay.
Me and my husband break up, I had to rent a town home
okay.
in North Hollywood, and we were neighbors. So that's okay. how that relationship started, and a lot of people used to come to her house.
Okay.
El DeBarge used to live in the building. I used to, you know, give him rice and beans and chicken every Sunday.
Really?
He wasn't doing anything with his life. Yes. Actually, I took him to Rick's house, and I took him to Eddie's house because he never met none of them before. I'm the one.
Really? Are you serious, Carissa?
He was like a son to me. He really a sweetheart. He was going through a whole lot of time. I used to pray for him. He was going through a whole lot.
So you know what? You were placed in that circle for a reason. And like how you say that you was praying for him,
right?
You never know what your prayers did.
His life, and you know, I just you know, every time I see him, I'm like, wow. But you know,
awesome. Yes. That is so good.
I used to be around Tina Marie a lot too.
Tina Marie,
girl, used to be on stage with her, have fun with her. She's a wonderful lady, beautiful person.
You was on stage. You was on stage with Tina Marie.
House of Blues more than once.
Awesome.
Yes.
See, and I've never been to the House of Blues. I already heard about it, but I haven't been there.
I had some wonderful people in my life.
That is so nice. Because you know, Clarissa, since I've known you, you're just the sweetest person. I know the first night we met, which was when, that was some months ago, huh? Because I was doing my first interview.
Right.
And when I met you, we sat there and we watched Empire together, remember? Right. Was it Empire? What were we watching?
Empire or Scandal. Probably Scandal.
No, no, no. It was Empire. We was watching Empire together, remember? Because we was like really, really on it. And then we just been friends since then. We may not see each other every day, but I have such a friendship for you, such a feeling for you, because you, it was just like easy, right?
Right.
It just came together so good. Dang, that is so awesome. Like, can't look, Carissa.
This will bring peace to you.
Carissa.
That's what people do.
Next time.
Reject the negative, always bring the positive.
Reject the negative, always bring the positive. And I'm going to say, Carissa, next time you go to some of them houses, you take me with you. And Prophet Michael, look, we want to, and Kevin, we all want to go. Okay, we want to have some fun too. But no, really and truly, shout out to the people that, you know, like she said, were angels around her, and that is such a
forget my past.
Made you forget.
Right.
That, you know, that's not everybody's story. You know what I'm saying? That's not a lot of people's story. You know, you have somebody to bring you out of the depression stage. You say you was crying for like 2 years. That's very, very hard. And if we have anyone out there going through any similar situation,
I would be crying, nobody would know inside of me. Everybody was getting high except me.
I definitely, so you be at a party crying, everybody. And you know why I understand that? Because I used to be at work sometime, and because of my past before I went through the therapy, counseling, and stuff like that, I would go in the bathroom and cry for hours. And then I was working at the Hustler. Well, I don't work there no more. But they gave me a good report, right? They gave me a good recommendation. I worked at the Hustler Casino in Gardena. And this is a beautiful place. This is one of my best jobs. I love that casino, right? But I was serving food. And so at that time, I just started going through the counseling and everything. And this was before I moved to Palmdale, right? And I would go in the bathroom and I would cry. Right. For like a whole hour, you know, and nobody would miss me, you know. I don't know what happened. God was just good. He was just like, yeah, you know, shout out to Hustler Casino, Larry Flynn. Matter of fact, I even waited on him, right? I was his, you know, his place was VIP. And so in VIP, we kind of, you know, everybody didn't get to go in VIP. And I worked in VIP, so I waited on Larry Flynn a couple of times. He was really nice, gave me and the girl a tip. And everybody was like, ooh, he don't give nobody a tip. So that means you guys are really, really good, right? So, yeah, so I know how you feel when you say that you would be somewhere and nobody knew but you and you were crying.
Right.
I know how that feels. And I know if somebody out there may be going through that, we pray for you guys. We send a prayer out to you right now. Holy Spirit, touch them right now. Comfort them right now in Jesus' name. And we just thank you, God, for this opportunity. Thank you so much because you are so good. Carissa, that story is like, ooh, so touching. I'm telling you, that is so amazing. Most people, who do you know that gets to go heal their wounds at celebrity houses?
Not many.
Definitely wasn't me. Look, definitely wasn't me. I was healing my wounds other ways, but yes. You know, that's such a blessing. That just goes to show that you're a little angel too. Because, see, you need other angels to help you because you're an angel, too. Because that's how you present yourself to me, and that's how I always felt about you. Like, she's just so sweet. She's just the sweetest little lady, right?
Everybody says that.
I didn't know that. But you are. You're just the sweetest little lady, and you have such a sweet spirit, right? So that's why God said, no, this is my angel. This is my daughter. This is not going to happen. This situation will not take her out. You know what's going to happen? I'm going to put her around all the celebrities, and she's going to be so joyful. You ain't going to have time to just, like, not go deep into it.
I guess I was born to be around them, but when I first came here, my first boyfriend was Muhammad Ali's attorney, and he let me every celebrity could take off that was out there. I was on every concert backstage. I met everybody I wanted to meet at those days. So
because you have
I
a sweet
really
spirit,
met a whole lot.
Yes,
I really was lucky.
Wow, you were blessed.
Yes.
Blessed and lucky. Luckily blessed, okay? She was luckily blessed. But she is such a sweet spirit, and I thank you so much, Carissa. I thank God, you guys, and we're gonna finish with a track. But we just want to give a shout-out to Pitbull, which is our sponsor, but we had a different commercial today, but we thank Pitbull. You guys, make sure you go get some Pitbull. It's a very good energy drink.
Yes.
And it's like athletes use this sports drink and a lot of different people. So make sure that you guys support Pitbull, support Prophet Michael, and you know, we just thank Roscoe Chicken and Waffle, Roscoe Media Center, and we're gonna go out with track number two from Prophet Michael. And Oh, you gave it back?
Track number eight.
Number eight. Okay, so we're going to go out with track number eight for Prophet Michael. We're going to play one more of his tracks. And what's the name of this?
God's Place.
God's Place?
God's Place.
Oh, so, and it,
come on over to God's Place.
Come on over to God's Place.
There
hey.
You go.
Hey, that's
you go.
Come on and go with me. Come on over to God's
Come on place. Over to God's Place.
Yeah,
it'll be so nice. Right. It'll be so. Track eight, please.
Yes. Say that verse again.
Yeah. Come on and go with me.
Oh, yeah.
Come on over to God's place.
Oh, I like
Produced
that.
By Rue Bass, Rudy Campbell. Featuring Rudy Campbell and Tosh Walker.
And thank you to my guests for coming on. And thank you, viewers, for watching. Beautiful
thank
people.
You,
I love you guys.
Thank you. Thank you, Gail.
Thank you guys for coming. I really appreciate you guys so much. I love you guys. Love you all, beautiful people out there.
And thank you, Kevin, engineer.
Every Monday,
thank you.
4 o'clock, I've been through it with Gail Davis. Okay, we're signing off. We're going to go to the video.
Yeah, I want to invite you guys over to God's place. This is Prophet Michael. Yeah, I want you guys to come on.
Come on and go with me.
Why don't you come on?
Come on over to God's place.
Don't you know I need God's place?
Yeah, yeah. Come on and go with me.
Why don't you come with me?
Come on over to God's place.
The voice for the word of comprehension.
Yes.
One of God's new son that's on a mission. Help you turn your life from wrong to right. You gotta seek God so you can shine in His light. Come pray, repent, here, forgive you of your sins. No matter of the creed or the color of your skin.
That's right.
Whether you're an enemy or just a friend, your spirit has been filled so you can come in. Long time coming, but now I'm here.
I'm here.
God on my side. Who shall I fear?
No
shall
man.
I fear tears from sins in my life?
No
Cause
man.
I got a God
no
loves
man.
Me day and night.
That's
he
right.
warns me when I start to see strife. His mercy falls on me so everything can be right. Come on everybody, come with me to see the light. To God place where you're free in life. Come on, come on and go with me.
Why don't you come
on and go with
come
me?
Come and go with me to God's place.
Cherish today before you think about tomorrow.
That's
cause
right.
life is precious, you know it was gone. Yesterday I dream about living for today. Cause time was it, I gotta take a stage point. The Bible is fulfilled in our last days. Obedience will make your way.
Yes, sir.
Let the Lord show you to God bless the light. Where there's only just day and it ain't no light. Stop the fuss and fight. Praise the Lord tonight.
Praise
be a one of poor soul, you can live right.
Live right.
To make a sacrifice. God, wisdom is a fruit, and it is a right spice.
Right spice.
See the world, rich is your life.
Rich is your life.
How to deal with worldly strife. Repent, because salvation promised everlasting life. Come on over to God's place, where the real bright lights.
Come on.